Hello and welcome to TalkFCB, and welcome back here to the channel, guys. And if you're expecting me in this video to shout, to cry, whatever really, to get angry with this team, I'm actually not going to. The reason for that is, I don't care. I actually, right now, I don't care. And you know the reason for that is, the players didn't seem to either. If they don't care, if they don't want to go and win this trophy, if they don't want to give everything out there to get through this second leg with a 3-0 lead, if they don't give a damn, if they don't want to try, if they don't want to stay alert, I don't care either. I am not going to lose any sleep over this. I'm not going to go and feel like it's my responsibility to get them over the line here. And the same goes for you guys. We have been here. We've been supportive. I've spent half of my life making these videos, looking forward to the games. We were so excited for this. You guys have been coming here with positive energy, with fantastic thoughts. Every single game we've been here, leading up to this now, every single week. We've been in La Liga, where we won it. We kept coming back time and time again. Now for the Champions League, all the focus on this game. We turn up and it's happened again. Roma has happened again. Most of my anger, I have to say, is at the players tonight. But as we know, it's a bit more to it than that. We know here that Ernesto Valverde, in my opinion, has to go now. He has to walk away from the Barcelona job. The reason for that is, I genuinely thought he'd learned. I genuinely thought that we'd come into this game and it would be different. That we would have a plan. That the mentality of the players would be different. Was it? Absolutely not tonight. We set up defensively, we look to contain, we look to absorb. Valverde said at the start of this game, we're going to play it as though it's 0-0. If that's how you play your football at 0-0, I don't want you anywhere near the Barcelona coaching position. He hasn't learned. And if you cannot learn from massive mistakes like Roma, you don't deserve to be in the job of Barcelona. And I have to say, I've almost been taken in by the Valverde spell. Because like I say, I thought that he'd learned, and I also thought that we were playing okay. Not magnificent, we haven't been terrific in the last few weeks. We haven't been terrific over his entire reign, really, but we've been getting through it. And I was almost sucked into the trap here that we've been doing well as a team. What we've actually done here is adjusted our ambitions, we've adjusted our goals to suit the style of Valverde. That's not really what we should have done. I myself can hold my hands out there and say, look, that's a mistake. Because what Valverde has done, he's basically made it so that if we scrape through games, if we get results, suddenly we're happy and everything else is forgotten. But that's not been the Barcelona way. We are willing to trade that. We're willing to trade that in if we got our hands on the Champions League, if we managed to just make our way there. But even tonight, with those same principles, with that defensive mindset, we've conceded 4 goals. Valverde's methods in the Champions League do not work. It's embarrassed the club once, it's embarrassed the club twice, and these players, they don't have the mentality now. With Valverde leading them, they look like sheep out on the field, they look like rabbit in the headlights, they didn't react at any moment. And the biggest thing for me was that goal. Trent Alexander-Arnold putting the corner in, it's an early cross, and the entire team there is asleep. If you can't react quick enough there to actually clear the danger, to be aware of the cross coming in, if you don't care enough there to get your head up, get into position, get organised, if you don't care enough, like I say, I don't care. I have lost the will here, not to support Barcelona. I'm not saying now I'm going to go and pick another team. I love Barcelona to the core. I love the values. I love everything that I've done right throughout my years at supporting them and also making these videos. I will never lose that love for Barcelona. But this team right now, and especially under Ernesto Valverde's leadership, that is not for me. What we saw right there once again tonight was an exact repeat, a carbon copy of what we saw in Rome, and that for me is not Barcelona. The team that I saw there tonight, they don't make me proud, they don't make me want to go and watch them, to be perfectly honest, and it was so, so embarrassing. And once again, we're on the receiving end of a massive, massive turnaround in the Champions League, and I'm gutted. I really, really am. I thought we could do it. I thought we could make it. I didn't think the players would let us down like this again, but you know what? They have. They chose that. They tried to work hard. They tried to do what they could, but ultimately, they weren't good enough. Once again, in the Champions League, we have fallen. And right now, guys, that's all that I can give you. That is all that I can give you, because like I say, I spend half my life doing this, and I'm extremely happy and proud to do that. I'm so happy to come here and make videos for you, because as a community, we have been so excited about this Barcelona team. We have been willing them on. We have been really urging them to have that success. And now, it just feels like they let us down. It just feels as though they didn't want it as much as we do. We want this more than anything. We go to bed at night thinking about this game. We wake up in the morning, we think about this game. Going through our day, it's all we can think about. We eat, sleep. We love Barcelona. But these players out there today, they didn't show that. They didn't show that they wanted this more than anything. Liverpool and their fans in the stadium, boy did they want it, and they got it. Ultimately, they've knocked us out of the Champions League. It was a great performance on the night by them. But as you know, we let them play like that. We sat deep with a negative, defensive mindset. And we said, look, come and beat us. Liverpool, of course, they fully obliged. They once again provided a massive turnaround. And it's just embarrassing. I feel embarrassed right now as a Barcelona fan. I'd never actually experienced this feeling of embarrassment before Valverde arrived. Since he's arrived, we've had league titles, yes. But in the Champions League, that's two colossal embarrassments now that I honestly feel like in my entire life, I won't be able to forget this. I won't be able to forget this kind of feeling. And of course, fans will be coming here of other clubs. They'll be laughing. They'll be soaking this up. And rightly so, because Valverde has put us in this position. The players out there tonight have made it so that we can be humiliated, we can be embarrassed, because they, out there on the pitch, didn't get the job done, and that really hurts. Because I love these players, I love many of them, of course, they've been here year upon year upon year. A lot of that squad, the core of that squad, have been through many titles, and they've given us more than we could have ever asked for. Yes, there's some new faces there, who in my opinion, are not up to the job. We're going to be dissecting that, of course, in more days to come. I can't do anything right now, it's full of emotion, it's full of heartache, but ultimately, guys, we have been let down again by the club that we love, and that really, really hurts. And I'll just quickly run you through the goals if you do want to stick around with this, guys. Like I said, I completely understand if you don't want to know, if you don't want to really associate with Barcelona right now, and certainly I can understand if you don't want to watch videos. I've got absolutely no problem. All I wanted to do really is put this video up because I've done a lot before the game. I've done all, of course, around the Barcelona games, and I wanted to see the job through. I actually wanted here to see the job through more than the players and the coach did tonight. It started with Divock Origi there scoring within 7 minutes. Henderson with the assist. It's a mistake from Jordi Alba. He actually heads the ball backwards, doesn't realise who's around him. Liverpool breaking through on goal, and the early goal, really, that's what we wanted to avoid. But Jordi Alba there with a massive mistake. I also think we should have closed down Henderson, and Ter Stegen either doesn't really cover himself in glory. He parries it straight to Origi, who has a tap in there. It was 1-0 then at halftime. I actually thought we got a bit better as the first half went on, but like I say, I don't even know if we were good. Maybe I'm sort of being sucked into that Valverde mindset that we think we're good, but we're not actually good. We're not actually playing well. It just seems like we are when you're sort of used to playing in this sort of negative way and sort of the way we've been playing for 2 years now. I think Wijnaldum then, of course, came off the bench for Robertson, changed the entire game. He scored two very quick fire goals. And again, we just sort of let it happen. It was sort of inevitable. You know, you feel like it's going to happen. You feel like what is going on out there, but suddenly there's no reaction. There's no change. Even from Valverde, he didn't seem to make a sub. He didn't even seem to want to make a sub until we were 3-0 down. That is not a coach that I want. At halftime, for me, something should have been done. Something there, decision should have been made, but it wasn't. And Valverde again backing out of that, deciding, now I'm going to wait till 60 minutes to do something with 3-0 down. And then his Pierre de Resistance bringing on Nelson Semedo. He brings a defensive change. He takes off Coutinho, which is justified, but he brings on Semedo. Why are you doing that? You know, we were looking for Malcolm at that point. We were looking for an attacking outlet. Because I tell you what, when Arthur came onto the field, the game completely changed. We had more possession. We had more control of the ball. That was the Barcelona that we're used to. We're going to these stadiums, and it doesn't matter home, away, doesn't matter who we used to play against. We used to come here, dominate, conquer. We did it our way. It was either our way or it was no way. And you know what? I wouldn't give a damn if we lost tonight playing on our own terms. Just like in Roma, if we'd have gone there, pressed high, played on the front foot, been attack-minded, I wouldn't have cared if we'd lost. If we lost that game, you put your hands up and you say, you know what? The opposition are better than us. But no, time and time again, under Valverde, we lose games like this, we get embarrassed like this, and we go out with a whimper. We didn't even give our best self today. We didn't even give Messi the opportunities there to get the ball in the final third because we spent most of the game again in our own half. That is not the Barcelona way. Arthur came on too little, too late. Malcolm came on, a bit more energy there, and suddenly then we had so many options down the right-hand side. There was Semedo, there was Roberto in space, there was Arthur controlling, there was Malcolm on the left, combining with Alba, and suddenly then we were playing some attacking stuff. We were getting chances, there were spaces to be exploited. But Liverpool then, of course, got their fourth goal and parked the bus, and they saw the job through, easy as you like from them. It should have come sooner. If we'd have started today with Malcolm, somebody there who can get in behind, who can exploit that space, with Arthur in midfield, somebody who can take the pressure off, receive the ball, and is happy there to be playing on the ball. But no, Valverde didn't want to do that. His idea was never to score. Everything he said before the game, it's all lies. It is all lies. He didn't come here to score. He didn't even come here to attack for 1 second. He was looking for counters, but even then, we never really looked like scoring. We never really looked here threatening as a Barcelona team, and that in itself, that hurts massively. And I'm not putting all the blame here at Valverde's door. Like I say, the players I feel tonight massively let us down. You look at the fourth goal there, the lack of concentration is absolutely diabolical. Even at Sunday league level, you switch yourself on. You react to the ball, you stay alert, you stay alive. But in that fourth goal, none of the players wanted it. And like I say, they've let us down as fans. We were so excited for this. All of our hope, all of our belief this season has been around the Champions League. We've put so much time, so much effort into all of this. And suddenly, it's all gone up in smoke. It's all absolutely catastrophic. And look, I am hurting right now, guys. I really am hurting. I'm sure that you feel exactly the same. And I wish I could give you more. I wish I could tell you something to go away from this video sort of feeling good. But right now, things are low. We're going to have to wait and see what happens in the coming days. Like I say, I believe that Valverde should say, look, I've won two league titles. I've done okay here. The players like me. The fans like me. I'm going to walk away from the job. That's what he should do after two absolute embarrassments at the helm of Barcelona. And the next season, with a new coach, more towards our values, more towards what we expect from Barcelona, we can enjoy Frankie de Jong, we can enjoy Matias de Ligt, we can enjoy these young players coming through, playing the Barcelona way and not Valverde ball. It's as simple as that. Valverde, for me, walks away tonight. But of course, out there on the pitch, the players undoubtedly have let him down, but most importantly, they've let us down. And I'm really sorry, guys. I just didn't want it to be like this. And it's happened to us again.